What up, you guys? Welcome back to another episode of Sweetie Man. Anyways, here today's episode, we're gonna be talking about how I got broke owning an exotic car. So, if you're new to my channel, I do have a McLaren 650S Spider. I got it last year for my birthday, which was back in towards the end of May. So, I'm gonna explain to you guys how I got broke owning this car, and is it good for you guys to own a McLaren as your first supercar? Yes, no. Is it good for you guys to own a supercar at a young age? So I'm gonna break it down to you guys and let me know what you guys think. So that being said, make sure you guys like, subscribe, and make sure you follow your man on Instagram, X_Sweetman. Nonetheless, let's move on with the video. Boom. So I've had this car, is getting to a year now. Like this next month is gonna be a year. The question is, how many times did I actually drive this car? That's the problem. How many times can you actually drive a supercar? I live in Canada, and obviously you guys do know Canada, the weather is brutal. So you owning a supercar in Canada, it's quite scary, especially during winter. I do have winter tires, which I just received the winter tires a couple months back. But as you can see, I'm in my studio. Reason why? Because my car is in the garage. So I do have two cars. Excuse me. Both cars are down. So that's, yeah. So I got my car right within COVID, but the restriction wasn't that much when it came to restriction. But the more I started driving the car, the more restriction we started getting. So that kind of messed up my ownership of, you know, having my dream car. McLaren has always been my dream car, and I'm very grateful and thankful to have owned this car. And no matter what I'm about to say, moving on, I do not regret the purchase. It was a great purchase, very emotional. So if you guys haven't seen the video when I collected my car, y'all browse to my channel and you should find the video. That being said, it's been ups and downs when it comes to owning this car. I'll say majority of the time, yes. McLaren, the excellent supercars when it works, especially the 650S, because obviously I think 99% of you are watching this video probably know that McLaren are one of the worst supercars to own, just because of the reliability of it. So that's why people don't really buy McLarens. They mostly go for Lamborghini, Audis, Mercedes, Porsches. So they don't really go with McLaren. Just a selected few that go through McLaren. And which that's me. So buying the car, I wouldn't say it's easy, but just like buying any other car, it's easy to get the car, but it's very hard to maintain the car. That's the problem, especially when it comes to McLarens or any exotic cars. But McLaren in particular, owning the McLaren is very hard to own a McLaren. So any of you out there with your dream car is a McLaren, yes, definitely get the McLaren. But you don't want to own it for too long. You want to get in, get out. That'll be my advice for you. But being on the same subject, when I first got the car back in May, I think within the first few months, I had to ship the car back to where I got it, which was in Montreal. I had to ship it back to Roosevelt's of Montreal because there were some problems that was wrong with it already. Off the bat, there were problems wrong with it. So I shipped it back, and I think it was there. So another thing with McLaren, having the parts, getting it fixed, it takes so much time getting it fixed because you have to get the parts all the way from England, and with all the bother and all that stuff, yes, it's quite a delay to get the parts, and the parts, they aren't cheap either, very expensive, and you can't really find any used parts around. Maybe in the States, you can find some used parts, but nonetheless, it's very hard to acquire the parts of McLaren. That being said, it stayed there at the dealership for, I think, maybe a month or so. A month, close to 2 months, it stayed at the dealership. So I had to travel back. So that was me spending, diagnosing the car here in Toronto. I had to give it to McLaren of Toronto to get it diagnosed. And that took about a month to get the car back from being just a diagnose. All right? So that's a month. And really, that's me owning the car within that first month, and I'm already having these kind of issues. Now, took it from Toronto, and once I took it from Toronto, I drove it, sent McLaren the report, we're going back and forth to see how we're gonna go about it, because I didn't want to take all the claims and try to fix it. That was gonna be expensive. The bills, I think it came up to about 20k, so I wasn't trying to do that. So I ship it to Rolls-Royce in Montreal. That cost me about $800 to ship it there. So ship it to Rolls-Royce from Montreal, brought it back after I think a month or two, give or take. Got it back, and few months after, I'll say maybe about a month or two, then I had to do my first service, which was to do an oil change. Before getting an oil change, I think I did a stage one mod on the car. After doing the stage one, doing the oil change, and shit started happening after that. So the first thing that happened was the fuel pump kind of went out, and I lost my keys, one of my keys, and the fuel pump went out. One fuel pump went out, which I believe it was the right side. I'm not 100% sure, which that's about $3,000. I think a little bit more than $3,000. Just for a tiny little fuel pump. It's expensive. So that went. Then the next was the fuel cap. The fuel cap just snapped. I don't know why, but I've seen this with a lot with McLaren. So that happened. Keep in mind, when I'm not driving the car, I'm still paying my monthly payment, which I've already shown you guys exactly how much my monthly payment is. If you haven't seen that video, I'm probably going to link it down in the description below or put it somewhere on the screen. Y'all can go check that video out. All right. And so regardless, I have to make my monthly payment, pay my insurance, and that's it. Now, how many times did I really drive this car? I'll say for the entire year, I'll say I probably saw it. Out of the entire year, I've probably driven it for maybe 6 months. Yeah, I'll say solid 6 months. Like driving it. I'll say the first three months of owning the car, that's where I drove it the most. And after that, we had winter, which winter you can't really drive it, which is crazy. And even like I said, we're in Canada, so when you buy these cars, you can try to drive it, but it's very hard for you to drive during winter. I got myself winter tires, but I didn't get to use it because the car, I had to send it at the shop, which I'll tell you guys why I had to send it at the shop. The battery died on me. I took it out after a long period of time without having the car because of the fuel pump. The fuel pump took about 4 months to get the fuel pump and get it fixed. And even when I fixed that, I had a problem with the instrument cluster. So the instrument cluster was kind of, it's flaky. So pretty much what's happening is when the car is on, the instrument cluster is fine. When you start the car, it start blinking. All right. So that's the issue, which currently that's what I'm trying to get that resolved right now at the moment. And I'm still not driving the car. You see what I'm saying? So we're getting towards summer. The weather is getting better. We don't have any snow. But yet, your guy can't even drive the car. So which is crazy. Nonetheless, it's at the shop. I'm getting, you know, making sure everything is fine. This winter that I took it out just one time, it was kind of good. And I took it out and the car died on me. The battery died. I had to replace that battery. The only way I could get the battery was getting it from the States, which that took, I believe a couple days. So that was pretty quick coming from the States. But that was the only place I could find the battery for the McLaren. If not, I had to go to the dealership. Getting the battery from the dealership is going to go anywhere from between $6,500 to $7,500 to get the battery, which they don't really supply you the same battery. They're going to supply you a Gen 3 battery, which my car has a Gen 1 battery, so they had to do a Gen 3 battery. So it didn't make sense for me to pay that amount of money to get a Gen 3 battery, so I decided to go with the same battery. So I did the install myself. If you haven't seen that, I'll leave it on the screen, or I'll probably leave it down in the description below so y'all can check it out. I installed it myself, so if you ever have problem with your McLaren, how to get the battery and how to install the battery, video is gonna be right here. Alright. Being said, after installing the battery, I took it straight to the mechanic, and ever since it's been there, obviously it's been taken care of. I'm not really too worried about it because they're gonna charge it, and also they're gonna make sure they're keeping it clean as much as they can, and obviously they're not gonna leave it outside. So far the car is being safe, but they're just working on it when they have time to check exactly what to go, fix it. And I'm not in a rush personally because I just want to get everything fixed and then seeing what's gonna come next. Now, that's how I kind of got broke owning this car, because more time it's sitting in the garage or not getting driven because I'm always working, so I can't really drive it, but I'm always making the payment. So that is kind of the trade-off when you buy a supercar. So any future supercar owner, that's the kind of thing you have to go through, especially if you live in a weather condition where the weather is really bad. You're gonna go through that. Now, a question you're mostly asking is, what's next for the channel? Are you gonna keep the McLaren or are you gonna replace it? In the couple videos before, I did said I was thinking of getting either a C63, a CT5 Blackwing. I also consider a Hellcat. Also consider a Nissan GTR. So right now, those cars that I've mentioned before, I don't think I'm gonna be going forward with those cars. And I think I've always said I'm not really into Porsches, but now I've been looking at Porsches, and that's thanks to the new GT4, the Cayman GT4 that just came out, just make me started looking back to Porsches. So I'm looking into Porsches. If I find something that's good, I'll probably go for it. So, but I don't think I do want a 911 turbo because it's just a straight line car. The McLaren 650S was kind of the same thing. So I'm not looking. I want that punch. Okay, I want to feel when I shift. I want to go back in my seat when I shift. So I'm gonna be looking at, alternative. So not a 911 turbo S. No, I don't think I'm gonna be going for those. Maybe a Carrera S. 911 Carrera S, so maybe I with the aero kit, maybe, I don't know. Let me know what you guys think down in the comment below, and let me if you guys have any similar situation. It doesn't have to be exotic cars, it could be a regular car, it doesn't matter. Let me know if you guys like. Personally, I've had really bad luck when it comes to ownership of cars, so let me know horror stories when it comes to owning your cars down in the comment below. That being said, I'm gonna catch you guys in the next one. All right? Yalla!